Hi everyone, this is Dr. Johansson making a short little video for you to help clarify and summarize some of the different microscopy techniques and images that I would like to make sure you understand and that are really important for studying cell biology. So the first is using light microscopy, which is what you've used in school, in the labs. Remember that most organisms are see-through, right? Like this paramecium here. So you can't see many details with the light microscope. Unless it's a plant where there's chloroplasts, those are nice and green, you can easily see those. But most of the time with light microscopy, we're going to use staining. Remember, anytime that you stain a cell, such as this cheek cell or these bacterial cells, and there are a whole bunch of bacteria on this cheek from the person's mouth, you have to fix the cells. You have to kill the cells. So you cannot see live cells when you're doing staining. So here's an example of an amoeba. This would be a live cell under regular light or bright field microscopy. And here is a stained cell. Okay, so these amoebas are dead. They've had dye added to them so that you can see them better. Also note that yes, you can see some organelles like a nucleus. And if I go back here, here's the nucleus. You could imagine the cell wall, the chloroplast, a cell membrane. Sometimes you can see a little bit of cilia, maybe a food vacuole, but you cannot see very many details with the light microscope. Okay. We can enhance light microscopy a little bit by using, as shown here, phase contrast, which gives you a little bit of depth, or differential interference contrast, which really gives you more of a 3D surface picture. So here's regular bright field that you would see a cheek cell if you didn't stain it. Here's phase contrast, which most of us don't get to do in the lab. And then differential interference contrast. So the nice thing about phase contrast and differential interference contrast is that you can look at live cells. Okay, so obviously these cheek cells have been taken out of your mouth and they're not going to be living much longer, but you can use these to look at things like paramecium and amoebas and cells that you have not killed yet. But again, not a whole lot of detail. To get more at the detail, we can use a couple different techniques, and one is fluorescence. Okay, so fluorescence means we have something that when you put UV light on it, it glows, okay? And it can glow different colors. There are some naturally fluorescing molecules, such as green fluorescence protein. This is genetically engineered into the cell to tag specific proteins, and we'll talk about this later in the semester. These could be live cells. So you can do natural fluorescence like GFP, look at live cells. But if you come over here to immunofluorescence, and immuno means we're using an antibody, and you have these beautiful colors, these cells are stained, fixed, or I shouldn't say stained, they're fixed, they're dead. You have to fix them and treat them in order to get the antibody in there and the fluorescence probe. Okay. So immunofluorescence, not live cells, uses an antibody to specifically target certain proteins or structures in the cell, as you can see differences here, and we can use multiple different antibodies with different fluorescent tags to have multiple colors showing different parts of a cell in one image. So you'll read about this in your textbook. To really get to fine detail, we need electron microscopy. And there's two main types. TEM stands for transmission, SEM stands for scanning. And hopefully you can see the big difference here in that transmission, you're actually shooting electrons through the cell here. And so you're seeing a lot more detail. So there's a whole bunch of little organelles. There's the nucleolus and the nucleus. Versus scanning where you're getting the surface. Okay, so this is some red blood cells, some macrophages caught in fibrogen network there. So you see 3D in depth, whereas transmission, it's more of a flat 2D image, but it gives you lots of details. Now, with electron microscopy, you cannot use fluorescence. So these colorations are all what we call false colored. So they've taken an image on the computer and then colored in the chloroplast and the nucleolus and the nucleus and the mitochondria. So it's false color. Same here. Here's scanning electron microscopy. So we've sliced through the cell so that you're getting a 3D image inside. This is actually a chloroplast, but normally it would be a black and white image. So the coloring here is all what we call false coloring. Okay, so again, you can do false coloring with lots of different image types. Remember that you're never going to be able to use fluorescence with any type of electron microscopy, whether it's transmission or scanning. You also might see different colors in something that's stained. So this is a plant root cross-section. You probably looked at these in general biology class, and they can use different stains on here to get different colors. But again, this is not fluorescence, it's staining. Okay? So with fluorescence, you're always going to have, if we look back here, a black background. Okay? Because you have to darken out everything, and then the fluorescent molecules light up. Okay? Even though this image has a dark background, remember you cannot get fluorescence with electron microscopy. So this is false staining. Okay, so a quick summary. One of the things I want you to be able to do is recognize different types of images. So bright field or light, we're not going to get into the details of whether it's, whether it's phase contrast, DIC, or just plain bright field, just notice that this is light. Transmission is where you can get more details. Transmission with false coloring brings out different information, structures. Scanning is going to give you a 3D image. These are macrophages that are false colored. Natural fluorescence, mainly we'll look at green fluorescent protein. And then when you have these beautiful different colors, you know that's immunofluorescence, which is using an antibody to stain things specifically. I want to point out, too, these two fluorescent images are also taken with what we call a confocal microscope. So a confocal microscope allows us to focus on one plane of the cell, like a thin slice, and get a much more a sharper image than just with a plain light microscope that's able to see fluorescence. So hopefully that helps you a little bit with understanding some of the different microscopy techniques that we will use to look at cells. Thanks.